ध्यानाविष्टतद्गते न मनसा पश्यन्त्यं योगिनः ध्यानाविष्टतद्गते न मनसा पश्यन्त्यं Avishta. Avishta means immersed. Immersed in the Dhyan. Dhyan means Samadhi. It means meditation. It means visualization of the object of our meditation. So dhyana avishta tad gatena manasa. Manasa means the mind. The mind is the abode of meditation. M means the mind, M is meditation. So dhyana avishta is the ultimate goal of our spiritual practices, to become dhyana. Avishta means to always remain in dhyan, be like a lotus in this material world, in the mud of this material world, but fragrant with the dhyan of the spiritual world. Anithya lila. So dhyana avishta tadgate na manasa pasyantiyam yogina. For example, one of my favorite dhyan is that I, in my spiritual form, I am circumambulating Nithai. Vasudha and Janvi. When Nithai is lying on his bed, I am serving them. I am going to the bank of the Jamuna and filling some water for them. I can feel the birds around me. I am there, I am not here. So, my biggest joy is to look at the lotus feet of Sri Vasudha, who is fanning with the chamara, and the lotus feet of Sri Janvi, who is massaging the lotus feet of Nithai with her soft, gentle, beautiful hands. And Nithai is in total rapture, unlimited remembrances are coming from Nithai. So you look at Nithai, you will remember everything. Yasmin vigyate sarvametad vigyatam bhavati. Knowing him means you know everything. So this is my most transcendental meditation. Dhyana avishta tatgate na manasa. Let my mind be entangled in this beautiful surroundings. Even the grass on which I am walking, it is crying for Nithai. It is fully conscious. Every particle is, every grass is like witnessing the beautiful love of Janvi, Vasudha and Nithai. Dhyana vishtadgate na manasa. पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः The pearl-like drops falling from Nidai's eyes are contain his remembrance. All his pastimes with Gaur Hari, all his pastimes with Krishna, all his pastimes with Janvi Vasudha, all his pastimes with Dwadash Gopal, his Sakhas, his Dasas, his Dasis, and the Eka Chakravasis. He is remembering everything on his divine bed. That's why I love this bed. When I touch the silken pillow on which Nitai's hand is resting, I feel I am so close. I am so close to Nitai. I am so close to Nitai. I am so close to Nitai that, that is the perfection of my life. I just have to lift my hand and touch his hand. ध्यानाभीष्टतद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनः आई फील द सॉफ्ट पिलो आई फील द बेड आई फील दैट आई एम क्लीनिंग द बेड द गोल्डन फ्रिंजेस द गोल्डन एजेस ऑफ द बेड शाइनिंग इट इन माय स्पिरिचुअल फॉर्म I'm rolling on the grass and embracing the grass as if my bandhus, my friends, they are the Shantarasa. In the grass are my friends, my bandhus. They are the most merciful residents of Eka Chakra. As gently, Vasudha's Chamara is flowing. It is being moved by Vasudha's, who herself is in divine rapture. She can't believe her good fortune that she is able to serve Nitai with Janvi. And Janvi can't believe her good fortune that she is able to serve Nitai with Vasudha. There is no jealousy. There is extreme humility. There is extreme love. Pashyanti yam yoginaha. And in this dhyana avishta stage, in this stage of total immersion in dhyana, in the mind, tat gatena manasa. That is when the fortunate soul sees the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face. That is when the Lord, the Supreme Lord, sees the soul face to face. Pashyanti yam yoginaha. Yogi means what? Union. Yoga. And that yoga is only possible by dhyana, by meditation on the form, on the pastimes, on the associates, on the qualities, on the attributes. On the abode. May I always be able to pick up the water from the beautiful river Jamuna, Maudeshwari Jamuna, in Nityeka Chakradham. When I touch the divine water, I feel that my body is turning spiritual. I am getting my spiritual form. This is all possible by lying down. Remember always, this is all possible by lying down. Nithai Lila Dhyan. Please try Nithai Lila Dhyan like I have prescribed, exactly like I have prescribed. And you will also be there like I am right now while recording this audio. I have forgotten that I am recording it. I have forgotten that even I am holding the mic right now and I feel in a total trance. I feel I'm offering prostrated downwards to Vasudha's lotus feet in the grass as she is moving the chamara, fanning Nithai, and I'm holding her feet and not letting them go. I'm crying, oh Vasudhaya, please accept me in these beautiful surroundings. Please accept me, please keep me always here. I don't want to go back to the material world. And then Vasudha is smiling. She's smiling. She's always willing. She's taking her lotus feet and putting on my head. This is the perfection. This is the way to get the Siddhadeh. When they touch you, then you get your Siddhadeha, like Ananga and Rupa touched Bhaktivinoda, then she became Kamala Manjari. Wow. Dharavali Dham. Sade Bara Vatsara. Then by the mercy of Vasudha's lotus feet, I am going to Janavi's lotus feet. And the beautiful lac under her lotus feet, the reddish lac, is making me faint, unconscious. Oh, I'm rolling there. Tavaivasmi. Na jiva tvaya vina iti vigyaya devitvam nayamam charana antikam tvadpadabja milalakshaha beshade devi jivata. The lac on your lotus feet is like my medicine, my elixir, my only ambrosia, though, my only hope. I'm a dead person in this material world. I'm a scorpion, I'm a python. Only hope is that lac under your lotus feet. That is my only hope. Oh, Janavi. Give me that lac. Shelter of the shade of your lotus feet, and I will get my life back. Devi Jeevata, it's my Jeevan, it's my life. I am dead without it. Tadparam Jamilalaksha Bhisanjaya Devi Jeevata. One can meditate on Janavi Devi's lotus feet for all eternity, but one will get fresh fountains of nectar. I don't even see them properly. But I still feel I'm there. I'm gently rubbing my palms on below her soft lotus feet. I feel that I'm there. And under the shade of her lotus feet, I feel I am there. Her pearl-like toenails are so shining, I have to sometimes close my eyes. I can't bear the effulgence of her toenails. Pesha Jair Devi Jeevataha, keep me there under your lotus feet, and I will be alive. I'll be alive in my spiritual form. Beautiful. I really love the birds which are chirping here because that makes me feel I'm there. They have started chirping more when I'm absorbed. So this is called as Pashyantiyam Yoginaha. Anyone who sees in meditation the Nitya Leela and enters there, he's a yogi. Yogi Yoga Vidhata Cha Yoga Pradarshakaha. Because Nitai is Bhakti Yoga Pradarshakaha. Nitai is Mahayogi. If you do yoga, if you do union with Nitai in the form of Nitai Lila Dhyan, this divine meditation of Nitai's pastimes, then you are there. You are one with Nitai in quality. You are one with Nitai in desire, in love. You are serving his associates. Dhyana vishta tadgate namansa pashyantiyam yoginaha. So this is the way to see the Lord, you know. Dhyan, Nitai Lila Dhyan. You say, I don't see the Lord, I don't see God. Baba, because you are not trying to see. You lie down and in the wall in front of you, you project any Nitai Leela and look at that and then close your eyes and internalize that Leela. Be there, see everything there. It's as simple as that. If you stand up, if you are upright, then finished. All your material life will start. If you, as long as you are lying down and meditating, you are there. Always remember this verse, Prabhupada's favorite verse. Dhyana avishta tadgati namanasa pashyantiyam yogina. This verse can even apply to Nitai himself, because Nitai himself is dhyana avishta and he's lying on the bed and he's dhyan. Is on Gaura Sundar, his dhyan is on Krishna. In all the five rasas, he's there. So he has so many things to do dhyan. You know, he is Mahavishnu, he is Garbhadakshai Vishnu, he is Shirodakshai Vishnu, he is Ananta, he is Shesha, he is Narayan, he is Ananta Padmanabh, Hari Madhav Keshav Janardhan Nirsinga. So he is. Shankarshan, Aniruddha, Pradyumna, Vasudeva, he is everything, he is everywhere. He is Lakshmana, he is Balaram, he is Ananga Manjari, he is the Dwadash Gopal, he is everything. He has so many things to do, Dhyana. Nitai is the ultimate Mahadhyani, Dhyani. He is serving Krishna. Chatravasana asana dhari rupa nishadina sevata Krishna swarupa. He is serving Nitai in every form imaginable in this, not only this material creation but the whole spiritual creation is full with Nitai. Antare Nitai, bahire Nitai, Nitai jagatmoy. And with pranams.